And today we're going to look at this. Tea break.
Hello again, BizArchie70 here, back again with the Frankenstein's Mill. Now, in today's episode, I need to make a top for this so that I can mount this. And now the electric motor should sit on top of here, and then this should sit in here. And as you can see, the top is missing. So, with some aluminium plate and some spacers, I'm going to make a top to sit on here that I can mount everything to. Let's get cracking. So that there is 78 millimeters in diameter. From the front edge. 78
millimeters in diameter. And there's the plate temporarily fitted to the top of the milling machine. Now I can carry on and sort out the rest of it. So I've also got to make a hole in this plate here for this section to go through, which is what I'm going to do now. But because this takes the tension up in the belt, I have to make it so that it can move backwards and forwards, so that it can slacken the belt and then tighten the belt up. So we'll mark that out and we'll cut it now.
Now on top of here in the front and in the back, you can see by these sections here, they are threaded holes. So I've now got to plot those onto the aluminium plate. I don't know whether you can see these pencil lines or not, but that tells me my limits as far as I can come this way with the hole in the top. This piece, this wheel has to fit in there and it's got some room to slide. So as long as I can make the hole this way, I can get that to slide in there. So this pulley is 161 millimetres in diameter. I'm going to make a hole in here, 161 millimetres in diameter. And there. Do is make it round. So I've got a boring bar attachment on here. We're going to bring it out quarter of a turn at a time, make this hole that I cut with the sawzall nice and round. See what your dad's doing, eh? Look, that's what I'm doing, making a home. A good boy. What's up, eh? Are you cold? You cold? Why don't you mind your basket, eh? Come here. Two beautiful round holes cutting that plate. Right. Pop that on there. Pop that on there. Okay. So the idea is when the spacers are on and this goes in, it goes in there and all of these line up. Just got to get a bit more 20mm aluminium to make the spacers out of. 20mm spacer steel, well, aluminium. What I've got to do now is I've got to shape it and make it fit the bolt positions on the top. test this first one. Plenty of room there. And I'll try it on the other side. Beautiful. So, lots of room there too. What I can do now is I can use this one as a pattern and make another. Okay, so I'm actually going to do the front. Very crudely as an example, like that. I'm going to mark that for these three holes here. That should be 168, which is going to be 84 mil. Center line there for the hole. Very sharp pencil. I'm hoping it reaches the bottom of the hole. Three holes marked there. And then, as an example, because the other hole is back here, I'm going to fit that in there. And then all of these pieces, I'm going to drill, tap, and bolt them to this plate. So when I take the plate off, these come off with it. And it will be drilled and tapped in reverse. So there won't be any bolts on this side. The bolts will be underneath holding them on.
These bolt heads here are hitting the frame and they're preventing this from traveling as far as it can, which means that the belt doesn't tighten up properly. So I'm going to have to countersink these so that this can pass over the top of them freely. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to cut these two pieces of aluminium down so they fit in here and level there, both sides, and I'm going to leave it square. And the reason I'm going to leave it square is I've got switch boxes to fit on here to power the motor, so I can fix them to this direct then. M12 volt in the hole. Pinched up. Okay, now we can put this back on the mill. Now, I can put this in.
So we've made this bracket. We've got some bolts. Those are just below the surface. I'm going to put some thread lock on them now. So I'm another step closer to getting this finished, this Frankenstein mill that I've got here. And that's the top plate now finished. So the next stage is to work on mounting the motor on the top so that I can actually use it. But we're a lot closer. And like I say, I've left this flat here so that I can fix brackets to it for my electrical boxes and everything else. Right, that's it for this episode. Like I always say, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please remember to like, comment and subscribe. It's completely free and it also helps the algorithm in YouTube share my videos out amongst other people who might enjoy them as well. Until the next time, it's bye-bye from me and it's bye-bye from the Frankenstein Mill.